Greetings to you all. I have just released a new book named Organization Intellect, Creative Manager, Genius Leader and the Taoic Process. What you see now is the cover page. It is pure black and white. So, as you saw in the screen, this book is about a mental revolution. Almost exactly about 100 years back, the person who is known as the father of scientific management, Frederick Winslow Taylor, in 1911, made a wonderful, powerful statement. So I am quoting it in the very front cover page, top, perhaps the first sentence of the book. In quote, in its essence, scientific management involves a complete mental revolution. In that sense, this book is about a mental revolution. So a mental revolution is just a strong term, perhaps very sincerely used by Winslow Taylor, Frederick Winslow Taylor. A scientific, another term for that is creativity. Having a creative shift, a shift in paradigm, a shift in perspective, that is mental revolution. And a shift in perspective requires, of course, creativity. What I call the creative intellect. Creative intellect is required. So this book, which I am just releasing into the market through Amazon.com, which I have written by the facility and support provided by the Chandragupta Institute of Management, Patna. Of course, I am very thankful to its director and my friend Dr. V. Mukundadas for actually inspiring me to write this book. So this book is looking at manager, leader and organization from a creative perspective. I am proposing the concept of explaining the concept of creative manager. I am proposing the concept of genius leader and Taoic process. The process that is the quality of Tao, tuning with nature. The book is named Organization Entelechy, E-N-T-L-E-C-H-Y. Intellectually, I realize now that most people, including highly educated people, are not that much aware of that term. Even if they are aware, they are not really sure about its meaning and the implications. In fact, intellect is a concept normally familiar among the philosophers. The term is present in almost any dictionary, of course. Intellect means realization of the original potential. So every entity or thing or phenomenon in the nature is there, provided by the intellect of the universe, of course. And every item must reflect or must have been given that intellect, its original potential to enter into the survival sustenance mode and to function by that, whatever potential given to that. We just cannot buy or eat a potential. So the potential for existence must be given with the entity itself. So if every entity has its intellect or original potential, I presume that organization or institution or every man-created thing or entity or phenomenon also should have its intellect. Like the automobile, the most preferred automobile has its intellect. You put in the key, turn it and it starts and the engine revolves. You release the clutch, put it in the first gear and drive. That's the intellect provided for the car. So too for a laptop or a mobile or anything made by man too. So I see the entire universe, every item, every identifiable item in the nature around has its intellect. So this creative manager also is from the same point of view, intellect point of view. As a human individual, human entity, there must be the potential of creating perceptions, creating understandings. Therefore, the creative manager. And genius too. If you look into any dictionary, the word, the English term genius means the attendant spirit of a person. Attendant spirit, the spirit, the early attendant. What's an attendant? You press the bell, the attendant appears. So when you press the bell, the attendant spirit is on. That is genius. So genius leader and Taoic process. Taoic process may appear as a slightly alien term. Tao is the concept of Tao, T-A-O, is now very well known through the work of several great thinkers and translators. Tao is basically an ancient Chinese concept. Tao means in good flow, in good tuning. So Taoic process is a very well-known concept, but I am using process exclusively to mean the nature process. Like I see everything in this universe as having its intellect. I see everything is in process in the universe. Not only that everything is in process, everything is a process. That's how I see it. So every nature process must be in Tao, in good tuning, in good flow, in good harmony, in good equilibrium with every other processes. So these are the basic creative perspectives I propose in this book. Finally, I am also suggesting that the future managers and leaders should be trained to discover their own intellects, their own Taoic intellect, their own creativity, their own creative intellection, which I call, their own genius mindset. Then only they become eligible, then only they can be in Tao with the work of enabling the entelechy of the organization as well as the people there. So that's all about this book. Creative manager is not a new term, of course, a lot of people use it. So the dominant aspect, the dominant entelechy of the creative manager is his power of intellect, intellection. Intellect is a very well-known concept. Even in the domain of psychology, the term intellect is not much discussed. There's a lot of knowledge about intelligence. I am differentiating between intelligence and intellect. Intelligence is all that knowledge, all that information that are gathered from the environment, from you, including out of one's own experience. So all those subjects that we learn, all those information and instructions and messages and data that are being fed into the entity, that are being made available to the entity, that are being imbibed by the person, I call intelligence, which can include the most advanced knowledge in any subject, physics or chemistry or medicine or engineering technologies. They are all intelligence. Of course, a much required tool for survival and sustenance. Whereas intellect, I am using it. I hope the psychologists and researchers in the world would perhaps forgive me for using the concept intellect to refer to a vastly researched expressions of human beings, like attention, thinking, perception, cognition, speech, imagination, visualization, and all such functions that have been conventionally separately studied as something of the human being. I am placing all of them in the setting of intellect. Attention, thinking, perception, cognition, conceptualization, internal dialogue, imagination, and so on and so forth. This comprises the setting of intellect. So a creative person is a creative person because of this unique configuration of the setting of intellect. Of course, everyone has attention, everyone has thinking, and all these functions. But they are all not trained, they are all in that rudimentary, idling way. So a creative individual is characterized by the creative intellection. Creative intellect. In this case, attention is creative. It can create new understandings. So his thinking is creative thinking. His visualization is creative visualization. His dialogues are creative dialogues. So every human being has all these intellect engines. I call them engines. Engine, by the way, the word engine means talent, the innate inclination. So I am using the concept engine to refer to attention, perception, thinking, and so on. So a creative person is characterized by a highly empowered engines of intellect. Therefore, in this book, I am giving little bit of details about the most relevant engines in the role functions of a manager. For example, intuition, synchronicity, imagination, visualization, incubation, reflection, all these are also engines of intellect. But these kind of engines are not that much required or relevant to the role functions of a manager. They are all relevant to other domains of so-called creative expressions, poetry, music, dance, theater, film direction, performing musical instruments, painting, and such conventionally most well-known creative expressions. So in other words, creative intuition or highly evolved engine of intuition or imagination is not that essential for the role functions of a manager. Therefore, I am discussing few of the critical engines relevant to the role functions of a manager in the first part of the book, followed by genius leader. As I mentioned, the genius I am defining. I think perhaps I am the first one to give a comprehensive definition of genius. Rather, I am giving a definition of genius on behalf of the fundamental expressions of everything in the nature. Everything in the nature, every item in the nature, from a blade of grass to the plants and the flowers and the trees and the rain and the mist and the birds and the butterflies and the dogs and cats and everything. In my observations of nature process, I could identify certain principles. Of course, you also please observe. As I understand, perhaps you can also understand all creations, all everything is possible from out of nature only. All the great principles that govern modern human technologies are actually originated from observations of the nature process, nature. So in my observations of nature process, I have identified five common factors or parameters or principles, whatever it can be named. They are firm, principle number one, firm, correct, elegant, complete, and Taoic. Taoic, I am borrowing the term from the beautiful Chinese perspective. But I am defining the properties of Tao by borrowing concepts from the great Zen perspective of cooking a cup of tea ceremony or Shanoyo. So according to that Zen perspective, the human entity who is setting out to prepare a cup of tea should have that attitudes of what I call Tao, that is about four principles, four properties or four manifestations of the mental state. It is tranquility, purity, harmony, and reverence. So the mind setting of a genius have this tranquility, purity, harmony, reverence, then firmness, correctness, completeness, elegance as the nature of the mind setting of a genius. Why I incorporate these observations of the nature to define genius is again guided by the normal dictionary meaning of the English term genius. Any dictionary defines genius, the first meaning will be the attendant spirit of a person. So what is the attendant spirit? It's a part of the nature only. You cannot write an examination and get the attendant spirit. So it's a linkage of the nature process. So if it is a linkage of the nature process, it must have the attributes which is available with every rose. A rose is a rose. Like I used to say, a cat is a cat. That firmness, the correctness, the completeness, the elegance and the Tao of a tree, of a cat. So that must be there with the entelechy of the attendant spirit also. Plus, the parallel term in the Indian Sanskrit is Sarga. Sarga in the classic Sanskrit dictionary, Amarakosham. Sarga means Swabhava Nirmoksha. Bhava means the property of the expression, the intellect. Swa meaning the self, that operating entity. Swabhava, the bhava or the expression potential of the entity being released, nirmoksha meaning to give expression. So there also I could linkage the content of the nature process in every human entity. Therefore I am defining genius as the one with the mind setting that is firm, correct, complete, elegant and Taoic. So when such an individual is in a leadership role position, I call a genius leader. In the next critical section of the book, I am explaining what is Taoic process. So as I told before, everything in the nature is in process, is a process, and nature process are Taoic, a firm, correct, complete, elegant, in good tuning. So in order to linkage the properties of nature process into the context of organizations or institutions, I am using an experiment, a very simple, very well known activity, that is cooking a cup of tea, of course, like in Sanayu. Yeah, rather I am borrowing Sanayu here, cooking a cup of plain tea. So using that as a model, as an experiment, I am identifying the factors of Taoic process. There are about 18, 19, 20 factors. And these factors are briefly explained. And at the end of the book, I am giving another 100 principles of Taoic process, which can be observed in every nature process. And in the end of the book, I am proposing the introduction of a training module for the management education programs. So I am actually differentiating between teaching and training. As of now, according to my review of all the relevant books, there is no clarity about teaching and training. For me, they are totally different. Teaching is about clarifying, explaining, describing some subject matter, something, or even an activity that is done outside to a student. Whereas training is about triggering and invoking and developing the potential, the capabilities, the contents in the trainee. If a manager's function is to choose decisions, decision making or planning or communicating or talking or having dialogues with people, they all require training. This creative intellection is possible only by training. N number of psychology students learn attention, thinking, perception, even about creativity. So learning theories about creativity, writing about it in the examinations and getting distinction and rank and all doesn't make any difference much. Because they are learning, there is a lot of intelligence about creativity. There is not much of intellection about creativity. So in order to become future managers and leaders, the young men and women who join the management schools, they should, along with educating them in the intelligence required for management, like corporate strategy or quantitative techniques or business policy or organization behavior and so on and so forth, they should be given solid training in intellect engines, so that they can look at something and understand the details and conceptualize about it. Or they can translate a conceptualization into possible, probable realities. So that they can themselves think about things. And so on and so forth. And they should be given sufficient sensitivity to the nature of genius mindsetting too. So I have devised a methodology called the method of creative intellect, which comprises concept, sense, analysis. I am proposing a new sense called a concept sense in this book, like the visual sense or the hearing sense, concept sense, the sense for concepts. So concept sense analysis. And the second part of the methodology is called a referral reality analysis, and third is called linkage network analysis. By these exercises, this analysis, analytical methods, one has to develop a referent reality perspective, a linkage network perspective, and a process perspective. So, the conjunction of these three perspectives, the perceiving entity that would become competent in creative intellection, including the creative intellection to identify and evolve one's own genius mindset. Of course, this genius mindset thing one has to evolve. That cannot be trained in a short time. Intellection can be trained. Attention can be trained. Thinking can be trained. So firmness and correctness and completeness and elegance and purity and tranquility and harmony and reverence cannot be that quickly trained. So that an individual has to identify himself or herself by the power of the creative engines of intellect. So that's all about this book. I really suggest that every, almost every individual, in fact, not only in organizations and institutions, can really benefit out of thank you.